गिवन कॉमोडिटी फॉर सच कॉमोडिटी मीन्स फॉर विच यू विल टॉक अबाउट मीन्स यू विल टॉक अबाउट सपोज इफ आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट डिमांड ऑफ टी देन आई कैन से दैट डिमांड ऑफ गिवन कॉमोडिटी अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस स्टेटमेंट अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस स्टेटमेंट गिवन कॉमोडिटी मीन्स टी गिवन कॉमोडिटी मीन्स टी अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस स्टेटमेंट गिवन कॉमोडिटी मीन्स क्लोज गिवन कॉमोडिटी मीन्स क्लोज सपोज टेक अनदर एग्जाम्पल डिमांड ऑफ बुक डिमांड ऑफ बुक डिमांड ऑफ बुक मीन्स सी और यू कैन से डिमांड ऑफ बुक और राइट अनदर एग्जाम्पल डिमांड ऑफ राइट सपोज डिमांड ऑफ नोटबुक डिमांड ऑफ नोटबुक मीन्स बुक विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज ए गिवन कॉमोडिटी बुक विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज ए गिवन कॉमोडिटी नोटबुक विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज ए गिवन कॉमोडिटी मीन्स डिमांड ऑफ एनीथिंग विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज ए गिवन कॉमोडिटी डिमांड ऑफ एनीथिंग विल बी कंसिडर्ड एज ए गिवन कॉमोडिटी सपोज इफ आई राइट हेयर ओनली टी इफ आई राइट हेयर ओनली टी मीन्स दिस इज नॉट ए गिवन कॉमोडिटी दिस इज नॉट ए गिवन Commodity. This is not a given commodity. Suppose I write here only T. I write here only T means this is not a given commodity. But I write here demand of T means then T will be considered as a given commodity. T will be considered as a given commodity. I hope all of you have understood. Suppose take another example. Suppose a book. If I add here demand of a book means Demand of a book means demand of given commodity. Book will be considered as a given commodity. I hope all of you have understood the concept of given commodity. Suppose means demand of anything will be considered as a given commodity. You can say like this, other name of demand of tea is demand of given commodity. Other name of demand of a book means demand of given commodity. According to this, demand means given commodity is tea here. According to this, given commodity is book. According to this statement, given commodity is clothes. According to this statement, given commodity is notebook. I hope all of you have understood means demand of given commodity. See after this. Now, see. I am taking here demand of X commodity. So demand of X commodity means X commodity will be considered as a given commodity. X commodity will be considered as a given commodity. So I can write this demand of X commodity or I can write this demand of given commodity means both are same. Both are same. Suppose if I am saying demand of given commodity, demand of given commodity. What is given commodity? See, according to this, given commodity is X commodity. Given commodity is X commodity. So I hope all of you have understood. See, now question is there. Question is here. Explain the determinants or factors of individual demand. Explain the determinants or factors of individual demand. See, DX. DX means demand of given commodity. Demand of given commodity. F means functional relationship. PX means price of X commodity. Price of X commodity. And see here, we are considering this. We are considering this demand of given commodity. Demand of given commodity, or we are considering this demand of X commodity. So I can say this price of X commodity or price of given commodity, because we are talking about commodity X. Because we are talking about here commodity X means, suppose if we are talking about commodity X, so X good will be considered as given commodity. Suppose we are talking about good Y, means good Y will be considered as given good. Suppose we are talking about good Z, then good Z will be considered as given commodity. So now I can say this price of given commodity. PR means price of related goods. Price of related goods. CY means consumer income. Or you can say consumer's income. Or you can say income of consumer. Y means income. In economics, Y represents income. In economics, Y represents income. And C means consumer. So I can say this income of consumer. You can say consumer's income. T means taste and preferences. Taste and preferences. EX means expectation about future price. Expectation about future price. Now, we are going to discuss all these factors. Question is there. Explain the determinants or factors. Explain the determinants or factors of individual demand. Individual demand. See, first factor is PX. PX means price of given commodity. Price of given commodity. Given commodity. See, price of given commodity. Listen, how will price of given commodity, how will price of given commodity affect individual demand? Or you can say demand of given commodity. Or you can say individual demand of given commodity. Again, I am repeating, how will price of given commodity affect individual demand of given commodity? Given commodity. See, suppose PX increases. PX increases. Demand of X means demand of given commodity decreases. After this, suppose price of X commodity means price of given commodity. Price of given commodity decreases, then demand of given commodity increases. Means there is inverse relationship. There is inverse relationship, inverse or negative relationship. Negative relationship. What does it mean? Relationship. See, what is inverse or negative relationship? See here, price of given commodity increases, price of given commodity increases, then demand of given commodity decreases. Price of given commodity decreases, demand of given commodity increases. See, both are inversely to each other. Both are inversely related to each other. You can say both are inversely related to each other. You can say price. there is inverse or negative relationship. There is inverse or negative relationship between price of given commodity and demand of given commodity. So here functional relationship is negative. Functional relationship is negative between price of given commodity and demand of given commodity. You can say individual demand of given commodity. But how will you explain this? See, I hope all of you have understood. There is inverse or negative relationship between price of given commodity and individual demand of given commodity. Now we will explain this. See, how will you explain this? See here. It is the most important factor affect individual demand of a given. My dear student, we will not write here demand of x commodity. Given commodity means x. Means we are talking about here commodity x. So commodity x will be considered as a given commodity. I hope all of you have understood the concept of given commodity. See, demand of a given commodity generally there exists an inverse relationship. See here, generally there exists an inverse relation. Inverse or negative relation between price of given commodity and demand of given commodity. What does it mean? See, it means that price increases demand decreases and price decreases demand increases. I hope all of you have understood. How will you explain this factor? Means px means price of given commodity and dx means demand of given commodity. See, it is the most important factor affect individual demand of a given commodity. Generally there exists an inverse or negative relation between price of given commodity and demand of given commodity. It means, what does it mean, inverse or negative relation? It means price increases, demand decreases, and price decreases, demand increases. I hope all of you have understood. See, next factor is price of related goods. But my dear student, please pause the video and note it down. See, next factor is price of related goods. See, we have discussed what is the relationship between demand of given commodity and price of given commodity. Negative or inverse relationship. Negative or inverse relationship. But what is the relationship between price of related goods and demand of given commodity? What is the relationship between demand of given commodity and price of related goods? See here. Second point. PR. PR means price of related goods. Related goods. See,